Yep, you see the title. Castlevania Lords of Shadow. Let's get back into it. I do not exactly remember where we left. Like, oh, we're at the end of one chapter.
She has the body of an innocent child, yet the wits and cunning of a seasoned predator. She will kill Gabriel in a heartbeat if she could. Beautiful Laura, who was turned many centuries ago, has lived a lonely, cruel existence ever since. Gabriel will have to be very careful from now on, as he can be sure that her mother, the one who commands here, is now fully aware of his presence, and that Laura herself still has some part to play in our tale.
Hey, look, everybody, it's the Great Hall. And that's the troll from Harry Potter. Oh, okay. My bad, ogre. I promise. Harry Potter Sorcerer's Stone. Ogre. Right before Quidditch. Wrong way always leads you to some sort of secret treasure. Remember that. That's video game 101.
Yeah.
And that was the end of chapter 6. Let's keep it going.
The butcher who commanded the castle kitchens fed the corpses of the dead to the ghouls. The efficiency of the queen's household is formidable indeed. The vampires drain the blood, and the ghouls feed on the remains. Nothing is left. Using his powers is making Gabriel far stronger than I anticipated. He will need more than physical prowess when he faces her. She can put a glamour upon his heart that will tempt him to forget everything he knows, even his beloved. She holds the next piece of the mask, and I fear that he will fall at the last.
For those of you who are probably wondering why I didn't like use my crystal yet, I'm saving it for a very important clutch situation. Alright guys, that's gonna do it for the gameplay. Next time we're gonna go deeper into the castle. Like and subscribe to the content, leave a comment down below. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. I love y'all, and I'm gone for now.